Hello and welcome to another Blueboard session. So this is actually the first Blueboard session in the section of the well-founded operator, and this is exactly the guy I would like to play with a little bit. So we are looking again at our good old running example and its associated well-founded operator, and I want to apply it to the partial interpretation that makes C true and no atoms false. Okay, so the first thing we will be looking at is actually how are the true atoms determined. This is actually something that you already know from the fitting operator. Well, but let's look at it again, right? So, of course, A is a fact. There are no conditions necessary. Obviously, A belongs to the set of true atoms of the result. What about the others? Well, here, again, keep in mind, we only know that C is true, but we know about no atoms that have been determined to be false so far. Hence, we don't know about not A, we don't know about A, we don't know about B, and we don't know about E. So we cannot really fire these rules, and this rule here, since C is true, is also inapplicable. Hence, A is the only atom that we can derive, and the only atom that is among the true atoms in the result. Okay, that was easy, and just a bit to warm up. Now let us focus in the rest of this Blueboard session on this guy, and this is actually the greatest unfounded set of our running example in the context of this partial interpretation, making C true and no atoms false. Okay, we have seen actually that there are two ways to determine the greatest unfounded set. One was more or less following the definition, and the other was to first compute all possible atoms and then subtract this from the set of all atoms. This gives us the impossible atoms, which is the greatest unfounded set. Let's actually do both of them. And first, let's look at the definition of an unfounded set. But again, let me give you another way to look at these things than just following the definition. So you may remember that a set is an unfounded set if all rules whose heads somehow contribute to the set have either been found to be inapplicable or satisfy the unfounded set condition, that is, have a positive body literal that belongs to this set. So the second type of rules you can more or less rule out by looking at the members, right? So for instance, here's a good candidate, right? So you can see, if you look at a set that contains E, then this guy is inside and you can't do it. For the other, you have to check whether the rule currently applies or not. So again, a set is unfounded if all rules have been found inapplicable or circular. Now if we find one rule that is not circular and is yet possible to apply, that cannot be called inapplicable, then this gives an external support and this atom cannot be added to the unfounded set. Okay. So let me just make this a bit more precise. So what do we have? Well, we have a couple of atoms, right? And these are candidates for our greatest unfounded set, A, B, C, D, E, and not to forget F. Now, who can support these guys? Well, of course, our fact A is supported here by the first rule, which is a fact. B is actually supported by the second rule, because keep in mind, the only thing we know is that C is true and we have no idea about any false atoms, so we don't know anything about A. And in the same way, actually, we don't know anything about A and we don't know anything about D, so that this rule is an external support for C. However, since we know that C is true, this rule here is inapplicable. It's the only rule that has D in the head, so there's no external support for this atom. So, poor guy has no external support. Now let's look at E. Well, first of all, we see the second rule satisfies... So if we look at the set containing E, then the second rule satisfies the unfounded set condition, condition 2 in the definition of an unfounded set, so we cannot use this guy. But the first one is still okay, right? So we don't know anything about B, we don't know anything about F. This rule can still potentially apply, hence it provides an external support for E. Now, what about F? Oh, well, F does not appear in any head of any rule, hence it does not have any support. And that's it, right? So if we look at now at the atoms that lack an external support, this is D, D and F, and surprise, surprise, this is exactly our unfounded set. And this is actually, in this case, also the greatest unfounded set, right? Because all the others have still a potential external support. Interestingly, this is very close to the way this is implemented in an ASP solver. So more or less, you take the atoms and you keep just one witness, more or less, for potential external support. And if this guy, for some reason, is invalidated, you look for another one. If you find one, great. If not, then this guy looks pretty unfounded, right? Okay, so this was one way to compute the greatest unfounded set. Let's look at the second one, where it's about possible and impossible atoms. Good. So again, keep in mind we know that C is true, but we don't have any false atoms. So what the only thing that we know right now is that this rule here is inapplicable, and otherwise the status is more or less open. So what we then do is we compute the reduct by simply dropping all negative body literals, and then see what is still derivable. These are then all the possible atoms. So what do we get? We get A and we get B. And since we have A, we also get C. And since we have B, we also get E. Okay. And now if we look at this, there are only two atoms that are impossible, right? A is still possible. Of course, A is even true, right? B is possible, C is possible, E is possible, but D and F are not possible, they are impossible, and of course, surprise, surprise, they constitute the unfounded set, the greatest unfounded set in this case. Good? Okay, so I hope this got you even a better intuition on what unfounded sets are and actually how the well-founded operator works. If not, let's have a second example. Well, see you in a sec, or perhaps a little bit later. Bye.